as many of you might know, I'm a second-generation children's book author illustrator. And the reason why I mention that is because a lot of the times I would go to the publishing companies with my father when he had meetings. And the editors always had a big shelf of books. It didn't matter who the editor was, there was always a big shelf of books. And when I would appear at these meetings, they would always go to the shelf and they would give me books. And so I had lots of books growing up when I was a kid. So some of the books that I remember being a part of my childhood was An Arrow to the Sun, Why Do Mosquitoes Buzz in People's Ears, Snowy Day, Madeline, and of course, Where the Wild Things Are. And these are books that I remember reading over and over again. And actually, there was one year in elementary school where we did as a play, Why Do Mosquitoes Buzz in People's Ears? And so I was the lion, and my mother made a lion suit out of corduroy, and I forgot what the mane was made out of, but we did masks, the plaster masks. And I just remember reciting the script and having plaster fall in my eyes while I was on stage. But just really remember having a great time. My library was filled with these books, these Caldecott books. These were the books that were a part of my childhood. They were the books that I went to over and over again. And I didn't necessarily pay attention to the fact that they were Caldecott books. The quality of these books to make you want to go back to them over and over again, to constantly find new meaning and to be excited about reading this book that you've read 100 times before. I think that's what the Caldecott seal brings, you know, to children's books. It lets you know that, you know, this is one of those books that you, you know, might treasure.